Hey everyone, my name is Draconix and welcome back to another scrim in Chivalry Medieval Warfare. Today, we have a fairly new team. Well, as new, as far as I know. They're new to the scrim series anyway. It is, what are they called now? FH, that is Forlorn Hope. I have no idea what that means, but they're going to be fighting the veterans, which are the Brotherhood. It's going to be Vicman taking on Loresso. Fork not going to be doing that much in the way of left mouse button. Stabs are quite powerful. He is falling for the feint a lot, and panic parrying will go down to Vicman. Mary is next. We know Mary for reverses, and already she gets a good hit on Vicman, and Vicman panic parries. Just outright panic in that one, just brutal. We have Askcold coming in next. He has the Sword of War. That is the fastest sword the knight can use. Mary jumping over his sword like it's a skipping rope. He's injured and goes down. We have Emperor next. Also using a Sword of War, but already took two hits. Three hits, that is one hit. Falls to the faint, goes down. I have no idea how to say that name, but he's dead anyway. Askcold looking to pick up the last one. It is Brutally left. That's all that remains. Askcold does well of reading the drags. A very convincing feint. Lucky Askcold did see that one coming. Then, well, he takes Boofy down. That's all you can say. Brotherhood win at the Kendo and get to choose the map and which side to attack or defend on. I need to figure out how to say that name. I'm going to call him Akal. Or Ak. Akal. Yeah, we'll just call him Akal because, you know, I'm not good with the names. I never have been. So, Akal it is. Your name is now Akal. May all your friends call you Akal. And may it haunt you for the rest of your life. God bless you. And welcome back, everyone. Here we go. Brotherhood did win the Kendo and chose to attack on, you guessed it, Dark Forest. Standard play, leave the man at arms behind, not harm, sorry. Although he is quite harmful if you think about it. He's a dodgy little bastard. Akal is going for the archer, so it looks like that the Brotherhood will have the armor support. Or the armor advantage, should I say. So far no one has fallen. Oh, there we go, Emperor kicking it off. Brutally gets the second. Pug's going to be team killing. That's not going to help his team. Pug is the last one alive. Gets shot. Low on health. Falls for the faint. Well, never mind. He did try and run away, but then got shot down by Akal. I told you, man. If you don't like the name Akal, choose something else. Otherwise, that's what I'm going to call you from now on. You asked for it. Is it Universe storming out with his throwing axe? That oil pot will not connect, no damage done. So that means all the damage is going to have to come from this melee engagement. The universe going to be picking off Mary. That will give Brotherhood the advantage they need to make something happen. We have Brutally here. She is in a 2v1. That drag by Vicman was beautiful. I don't know how, but Vicman somehow ended up in a 3v1. It seemed really in heavy favour of Brotherhood, and then all of a sudden it just changed. And Pug going to be going down. I think he managed to do a bit of damage to Loresso by trading, but it wasn't enough to kill. Brotherhood wiped, ready, or almost ready, should I say, to come back in. It already damage being done to Benjib. What a name. He cannot take another hit, otherwise he's not going to be able to stay in any engagement for too long. The gank on Mary will bring her to fall. We have panic parries by Loresso. And we have Askcold picking up two kills in that little skirmish. And the cart will get moved. 7 minutes to play with, that is plenty of time.
Alright, yes!
Okay, that axe is going to have done a ton of damage to Pug, and that one connects to Vicman. Two players on Brotherhood, fairly damaged now. You have to play very careful. But luckily, they are using teamwork to their advantage. And Emperor is the last one to go down for FH. And that is it. That's the next stage of the objective. Let's have a look at what everyone is doing. Emperor is top of the team. And, well, he's MVP and highest factor for his team, FH. That is 6-2 with one assist. Universe standing up on top as MVP, but joint highest fragger with Vicman. Universe has 4-3 with 3 assists.
We are in agreement.
And I don't know what Brotherhood is thinking, but they could leave these players behind. I mean, yeah, they would have an archer shooting from behind, but if they was careful, then, you know, that's two less players that would be trying to defend the cart, because now they are dead and will respawn forward and, you know, they'll be able to defend the cart. Pug gonna bring down Loresso. It's just Mary surrounded. Nice parries though, but just wasn't enough. Vicman takes the kill. Yeah, throwing axes going out. Broofy has took damage from throwing axes, and it looks like the Emperor has too. The cart makes it incredibly difficult to fight. Brandy start doing heavy damage. Benjamin takes the kill on Broofy. Then Mary coming in, picking off Universe. Mary's the only one at the cart to defend anyway. We do have Benjib and Pug ready to attack, but Pug instantly goes down, loses his head, just Benjib left, and he will go down to Mary. That is a full wipe for the Brotherhood. I'm pretty sure Pug just went through the floor there. Not quite sure what happened. Mary pushing up semi-aggressive, not all the way. Oil pot well placed will burn the archer and one of the knights. Pug is all alone though. This is really bad positioning. The best thing he can do is dance around them, try and cause them to hit each other, but no, he's holding on. He's dodging. He's doing it. Does eventually go down though to Mary. That was unfortunate. He did create enough distraction for his team to push the cart. It's a 2v3. 2v2. Although one of them is an archer. Maybe it's a 1v1. If you don't count the archer shooting in the fight. And Akal takes the kill, and Benjib was shot down in his prime, ready to attack, and got attack blocked. That was lucky. If Loresso would have got caught by that oil pot, I'm pretty sure he would have died. Mary is not trying to attack, just running around, ducking, trying to get to safety, gets blocked by her own teammate. Vicman gets a double there. Broofy in a 2v1, low on health, and is now on the ground dead. Pug takes the kill, and they will push the cart. Brotherhood earning themselves plenty of time. Everyone in Brotherhood is over rank 50. Interesting. Maybe that's a requirement. Two picks for Brotherhood, looking really well for them. Oh, that'd be a third. Luckily, Akal does get a pick for FH, but it's not enough. That card is going, and it's going fast. If Boofy falls off there, then the others will gank her, but she stays up there. See, now she can go down and, with the rest of her team, try and make something happen, like stopping this cart. Universe gonna go down to Mary. And they did just what I said they were gonna do, make something happen, and they did. Cart is stopped. Just under 12 minutes. Vikman obviously spawned first, waiting for his team. FH gonna push up aggressive, but not so aggressive that they can possibly get flanked. Oil pot will burn the archer and the vanguard. It is early damage, so they'll take it. Vikman gonna go down early to an arrow. Emperor gonna team kill a cow. That's not what FH needed. It is just the Emperor left to defend that cart. He is badly wounded, and now he is dead. Killed in his prime by Benjib. Mary making a desperate sprint for the cart, but it's at the point of no return. It just needs a tiny flick and... a flip. Yeah, you probably heard that. I don't know whether you did, but I flicked my mic. Only slightly, you know, because it cost money. But anyway, that is the objective. Let's have a look at everyone who's doing. By the way, I like the name. Mason chose. Emperor still MVP and highest flag for his team. Going 10-8 with 9 assists. Askold is MVP and joint highest fragger with Vikman. Askold is 13-6 with 9 assists. Match has been paused. Pug has crashed. His inferior technology in his toaster just wasn't enough. So we will return when he gets back. Okay, welcome back. Okay, it seems like a full stack at B for FH. Ooh, that's called taking a rather sharp axe to the chest. Oh god, that's one to the head. It was just throwing axe going out each side now. Did anyone else see Askold do some kind of weird quick parry that seemed to go into the... Or was that just me? Oh wow, that one... That's lucky to be alive, to be honest. The brandy stock can one-shot a man at arms. He was lucky to have lasted two hits. Wheels are returning, but it is gonna be Loresso to contest it. He's just kicking them away. That buys his team time. And how the fuck did I get there? Camera, please! Emperor's going to pick off Vikman. It's a good start for FH. For the defense of the wheels, anyway.
I've got your back, brother.
Mary has no stamina. She's just going to throw the axes and then fall back.
Of course. Yes. Behind us.
Benjib is using the brandy stock. Yeah, I hate that weapon, but... Yep, that's just me. It is competitive viable. Once again, it's just a full stack for FH. But they aren't trying to split the team up, they are just going for the full... Yeah, let's stack bomb site A. And it is not paying off for them. Two members have already fallen, it's just Emperor left to stop the wheel. Loresso with a nice target switch, but he's in a 2v1, loses his head. Hopefully Akal will have bought his team enough time to get up there, but oh yeah, the wheels have stopped.
Nice.
universe goes down. Rupee takes the kill. Rupee is looking for the second kill on Vikman. And she gets it. That's a double. Pug gets shot down right in his prime. Again, we have some weird full stack strategy where they will push forward aggressive sometimes. It's not the normal, I'll give them that, but it's, so far it's working. Oh, two picks for Brotherhood gives them a good chance of turning these wheels now. That's a third pick. The rest of us are the only ones to get kills in this engagement. Four. Oh, he gets two, that's a double. He needs to get the ace though. He has to kill all of them, but no. Not gonna happen. The wheels are returning. FH cannot possibly spawn in time and get there. Last objective now. Score's pretty much the same. Yeah. This part's usually over so quick that I can... Yeah. You just use your eyes. You know what's going on. You're clever. Have one person at C. Universe does not know that, but he's about to find out. It is going to be Woofy to take him on. Oh no, I don't know which way he's going to go, but he has been noticed by more players. It seems they're going to gank Woofy and then gank the other player. Rupee did well to read the first fight, but the second one did catch her off guard. Universe is going to go down. Gets ganked himself. Vikman in a 2v1. He can win this, but he doesn't. Akal takes the kill. Such a silly name, Akal. Then again, I did choose it. Nice backswing by Pug. Yes, backswings are possible with man-at-arms and they can be very effective. Going to be Emperor to try and bring him down. But no, Pug's playing it very smart. He's doing the parries and then riposting in to the objective rather than at his opponent. You know, he's doing the objective rather than trying to get the kill and then to the objective. Because he was in a 3v1. He wasn't going to win. So yeah, he went for the objective points and progression. Rupee receives a reverse. Doesn't see the player behind her. Universe takes the kill. Universe is on a roll right now. He's got to stay alive though. His teammate will need him. Well, he doesn't have a teammate now, but Loresso will kill his teammate. That leaves Universe in a 2v1. Universe misjudging that reach, or just didn't parry in time. Emperor takes the kill. God, point B is almost destroyed. I think that's Pug over there. Yes, it is. He was the only one that was not in that engage. He was the rat. Oh my, he missed that family member. Hey, I wasn't the only one that noticed that, apparently. And will FH just let go of guard point A, or will they try and keep it? Where are the Brotherhood? Oh, they're already here. They're quick little bastards. The kick is OP. That guard point is under heavy assault. That is two players hitting it. Two players defending the hitters. That's three on it now. Family members are exposed. That is another one down. Losing C. And right now is a bad place to be in. And I'm sure this is Pug. Yep. There he is, ratting away, gnawing his way through the wood. The enemy knows he has to do this, and he has to do it now. Oh, he was one away from ending it. Oh no, there was two left. Oh, did he hit one and he didn't die? He must have. FH are just going to pile up on this open area now. They aren't going to let it go. Not with their defeat anyway. And here comes the people who want to relieve them of their guarding duties. All they need is one assassin to get in there. He misses! That backswing just about got it. Well played. That is the half. The time was, let's have a look at that. Time says 11:28. What a half. And I will see you for the second one. Stick around.